welcome to Two Food Tuesday, where I take one ingredient and use it for two reasons. My name is Sarah Manaresi, and welcome to my kitchen. This week, I'm taking meal prep, whatever day you won't do your meal prep, if you do meal prep, to the max. I have a chicken here, and let's just start off really easily. Most kids like chicken, so this is a foolproof, yummy, yummy option for you. You can do this with two chickens, or you can do this one chicken, and for this week I'm just going to use one, but you can totally do this with two. This is a little bit on the larger side. If you do it with two, I recommend about 3 pounds. This is probably close to four and a half. I don't need 6 pounds of chicken this week, but whatever we're going to make here, you can use in leftovers, and it's going to be fabulous. So what I've already done is I've taken a couple of yellow onions, and I've sauteed them in some olive oil, salt, and fresh thyme. And then when they were all golden brown and delicious, I added a quarter cup of white dry wine. And we just put this on a sheet pan like so. I set the oven to 450 degrees. And then what I've done here is I have a quarter cup of unsalted butter, about 1.5 teaspoons of kosher salt, about a teaspoon or so of freshly ground black pepper, and some fresh thyme as well. I believe about a tablespoon of fresh thyme that I chopped up. And here I have a delicious looking chicken. This is butterflied, and the way you do that is that you pretty much take the bone out that's in the center there, you know. And I had my butcher do it because my knife skills, they scare me sometimes. Not that I'm horrible with a knife, but I'd rather not to show you how to do that on video and then end up all over the internet. Breaking down a chicken takes practice, and it just was easier for me to say, hey, Mr. Butcher Guy, can you please take butterfly my chicken for me? So what it looks like is that it pretty much takes out the center bone just like so. I've loosened the skin a little bit already. It does get a little tight in there. And then I'm just gonna take this butter mixture and I'm gonna stuff it in here. And this is just gonna add a nice layer of flavor. In the end, you're gonna end up taking the skin off if you so desire, of course. And so this butter is just really meant for flavoring and making things gain that salt and the thyme getting all under on top of that chicken and, you know, making it crisp and delicious. And then I'm just going to stick this in the oven for about 35 minutes. It really depends on the size of your chicken. It will cook a little faster just due to the fact that you have taken that center bone out, and this leg is giving me a little bit of trouble. And this is messy. It just is, and it's funny to watch. Go ahead, laugh. It's all right. I'm not pretending to be perfect. You know, I get a lot of questions, you know, where'd you go to culinary school, and did you go to school? And no, I didn't. I'm a home chef. I wouldn't even call myself a chef. I'm just a home, stay-at-home mom who found a passion of cooking. And so, you know, like techniques like this, it's a learning curve for me as well. So if you're laughing hysterically right now because of my lack of beautiful skills and I have butter all over my hands, yeah, that's totally okay because I'm laughing too. So it's totally fine. You know, the thing is, it's just to be really confident in trying new things, and if it works out, great, and if not, that's okay too. But you won't know unless if you try. And then, so that's pretty much how I started my quote-unquote career as cooking. You know, when I first got married, I couldn't cook anything. Like, I could cook spaghetti and, like, just basic chicken breast, but something like this I would never, ever attempt to do. So just showing that there is hope for us all when if you're not confident in the kitchen yet, well, that's okay. You just learn the skills, do through trial and error, and get butter all over your fingers. It's kind of therapeutic, actually. So anyway, I'm going to cook this for about 35 minutes. It might take a little bit longer, and then I'm going to let it until it gets to 165 internal temperature. And that's the breast. The thyme is generally about 85 degrees. And then I'm just going to let it rest for about 10 minutes before I carve it, and then dinner's good to go. Now, you can take the leftover onions here, and you can make wraps with it. I have a recipe for a fabulous wrap because I'm all about lunches, making lunches out of this, or you can make extra dinners with it too. So the chicken is just gonna be really flavored. It's not heavily seasoned, so you can use it in a lot of different recipes. And I hope it becomes a family favorite of yours. Hopefully it'll look a little prettier than what I just did here, but that's okay. Like I said, it's all learning curve. We all just need to get outside of our comfort zone and get some butter on our hands. So I hope you're having a wonderful evening, and I will talk to you later. Bye!